I've let things cool off. I've let things die down. I didn't want to add insult to injury, bring things up too soon, and ruin the guy's chance at grabbing a Valentine's Day date. But it's time. January 17th, 2021, I beat at Boomie XD in Experimental. It wasn't even close. A banger of a two-stock that left a ripple in time and space. Archons of the multiverse are still in discussion at this very moment, debating if I transcended timelines and should be assassinated by their most OP duo, Hit from Universe 6 and Artemis from Universe BMG. After the match, my FBI agent texted me saying, "What the fuck? Who's playing on your account right now?" I replied with a picture of my left eye, a fully formed Mangekyo Sharingan, with a voice memo attached saying, "It was I watching you this entire time, Bob," in fluent Japanese. The Boommeister himself was left in a state of shock and disarray. I can only imagine the fallen three-time world champion was shell-shocked, deaf in both ears, seeing double as he navigated to Twitter to tweet out that he's been defeated by Diffensive and Experimental. I do not know why he sent out this tweet. Maybe he was trying to get in front of the drama. Maybe it was humility. Maybe he thought he was dreaming and sending out that tweet would snap him out of his nightmare. But the nightmare only continues. Because this is the new reality. Salty and Seething Boomatron 8000 decided to share the secret of my strategy to none other than Aqua's Mystic on Twitter, saying he hit me more than me hit him. I don't mind him throwing my strategy to the wind for anybody to hear and see. I've been saying that same piece of advice for years. What does rub me the wrong way, though, is the abomination that occurred after the biggest upset of 2021. I guess the higher-ups of Tempo Storm caught wind of this epoch-defining match and decided to drop Boomie from their roster. If I had known that delivering an absolute stomp onto Zach would have resulted in such an unsavory turn of events, I would have stayed in my lane. I would have taken the L like anybody would have expected me to. Tempo, my DMs are open. To sum it all up, it just means that I'm the better player, right? Yeah. I'm way better than Boomie at Brawlhalla. Well, that's just not true. That's an absolute lie. All right, here's how it really went down. It's like 2:38 in the morning. Real degenerate hours. We're playing Brawlhalla, right? We queue up. I think nothing of the match. Matt Groening's new season of Disenchanted just came out on Netflix. So on my other monitor, I am binging the show while playing Brawlhalla. I'm autopiloting. I'm not paying attention. I'm half playing, half watching, listening, whatever. I don't think twice about what's going on. I didn't even know this was Boomie. I assumed it was a random until he knocked me out for the first time because it was a little bit of style. I was like, oh, it's probably not a random. Lo and behold, it's Boomie. We're both playing Greatsword Legends. I'm playing the new one. I'm playing Full Metal Alchemist version of an orgy gone wrong. And he's playing God Poseidon Thatch's daughter, Shark Week, right? It's not a big deal. What is a big deal is we're kind of on the infamous map, you know, Shine Like Gross. And the match really, until this point, wasn't anything special. He knocked me down style. I checked it. I was like, oh, crap, this is Boomie. Whoa, cool. All right, he's up by a stock, nothing out of the ordinary, we go at it, you know? But, as you guys know, from the title, the thumbnail, the tweet, the entire premise of this video, I beat Boomie here. Who's at peak performance at 2:38 a.m. in the morning? Me, the degenerate Diffensive, ha-ha! Who's not at their peak performance? A three-time world champion. Who normally plays grand final sets for $50,000 at like 8 p.m. Eastern time, right? So how does this go down? I mean, I equalize the stocks and it just goes from here. This is the end of the scripted part of the video, if nobody noticed. So we go buck wild. We go in for it. I don't have a weapon. I don't care. I play on arm. This is how I do it. Do I try to go get the weapon? No, I don't. Do I get a recovery? Do I get back to stage? Yeah, I do. Do I get a little double delete into a down air? I do. Do I go for the weapon? I still don't, because that's what anybody would do, and I'm not just anybody. If I want to be real here, both of us were whiffing a ton, signatures, follow-ups, punishes, whatever. Do I get really dirty unarmed punishes on Boomie constantly? Yeah. Do I get a gravity cancel D-light or D-sig kill on him there? Yeah, I do. And you know what? I'm up, not by an entire stock, but like three hits. By like three hits. At any point, Boomie could equalize this match. A naked side sig for me shouldn't have hit. Offstage gameplay against a hammer. He doesn't respect me, and I get it. His PR, his like world record setting, his CMR, everything. I'm not ranked. I don't have any cash money earnings. My cash money rating is $0. I have not won a dollar from Brawlhalla. Do I absolutely destroy him here with some unarmed? And did I almost add insult Andrew with the gravity cancel down sig? Yeah, I did. I beat Boomie. I two-stocked him. I stomped him. I absolutely humiliated him. But here's the thing. I suck at this game. You might be wondering, hey, Diff, why is this recording still going? Why are you going onto the Ben 10 map? Why are you up against this KHY Taros? Why would you include this in the video? You just stomped Boomie. You just showed absolute dominance. Well, let me show you how fucking bad I am at this game and how everything comes down to its circumstance in the moment. This is like a few matches before, after, I don't remember. I didn't pay attention to what just went on. I get absolutely dominated by this guy. He hits me with 8 down sigs with Taros' hammer and I'm dead. He's up 180 damage. My mental shattered, absolutely broken alive. Yeah, did I beat a world champion? Yeah, do I absolutely suck at the game? Yeah, maybe Boomie had an off second or two. You know what? Maybe he wasn't trying hard because he was playing against someone who sucks at this video game, right? Now, all that being said, I did absolutely come back and crush this Taros. Did I bring it all the way to end game? Did I bring it all the way to me almost dying and only the defense of Magyar saving me? Yeah. Yo, Pippin Daskopakalopoulos, sorry I ignored your invite. I honestly don't know who you are. Boom! Yeah, I beat the Taros. I am kind of the fucking best, but I'm just goes to show that it's all down to circumstance. The time, the place, etc. I am the best. And you should subscribe to this channel and comment down below. Ho ho ho! Boomie got wrecked! Because it's the appropriate thing to do. This is my first YouTube video in like months since like the BCX animation. I've been on kind of a hiatus of this and Twitch. Yeah, that's how it goes. I'll probably be streaming when this video goes live. Come check me out. Videos will be releasing throughout the week of varying content. Wink, 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 wink. This timing is very deliberate. And I'd like to thank all my Patreons. I don't understand what kind of aliens you guys are. I don't know what galaxy, universe, whatever you're from. I don't recognize any of your names, but I really do appreciate that financial support. We're in it for the bag, baby. We're making it rich. Every like is like 10 cents in my pocket. Like the video. Subscribe to me on Twitch. I'm going to become a millionaire. I'm playing video games. Let's fucking go.